Friends, in the last video we have seen how to create our own username and password using in-memory authentication. Okay, Spring Boot by default provides username and password. If you enable Spring Security, Spring Boot provides by default username and password. If you want to access any endpoint, we have to log in with that username and password. Then only we can access the endpoint. Now we want to give our username and own username and password. That's what we have seen in our last session. While defining username and password, we have to provide roles of the particular user. Okay. We have not seen use of these roles, but we have done last session, last video. Okay. Now in this video, we're going to play with these roles. How to use these roles, we're going to see now. Okay. Before that, I want to show the two controller classes. This index controller, having one method called index method. This method return whenever you access a root path, localhost colon 800. Whenever say this particular method get a return, because I have not mentioned any path here, just I mentioned get mapping. This is the index controller. When you go back to the Pelcom controller, I mapped with api/user, api/admin, api/superadmin. I have given three different endpoint here. All are accessible by /api/user/api/admin/superadmin. My intention is I want to provide some restriction to access the particular endpoint. Whenever user log in as a user role, that particular person should access this particular method. Whenever user logged in as an admin role, that admin person can access particular this endpoint. If user logged in as a super admin, the super admin should be able to access all these methods. This is what I will going to configure now. Let's see. If you want to implement that, we need to overwrite another method called configure method. There is a configure parameter with HTTP security. Okay, this is the method http.authorizeRequest.antMatcher. In the antMatcher only we need to tell which path can access by which user. Okay, which path can access which user, that definition we can tell here. Here users, my endpoint start with api/user. Right, you start with API followed by user, admin, and the super admin. Now api/user.hasRoleUser. If logged in user having a role of user, that person can access this particular endpoint. AntMatcher api/admin. If person logged in as an admin role, the logged in person having admin role, that person can access this particular page. AntMatcher api/superadmin/hasRoleSuperAdmin. This particular endpoint can access by only super admin. Then antMatcher root path. This particular root path can access anyone. And form login. Okay. Whenever you access this particular page, the form login will come that provided by Spring Boot. In that form login, we have to log in with a user and password. If that user is having a user role, that user can access this particular endpoint. If user is having an admin role, he can access this particular endpoint. If user is having a super admin, that user can access the particular endpoint. Okay, according to this configuration, the user can access only this, admin can access only this particular path, super admin can access only this particular path, right? Okay, let's start the server now. Server is started now. As I mentioned before, if you say root path, it's give the in this is the index, this is the index page that's coming from index controller. Okay. Now going back to welcome controller, if you want to access the particular user, I have to say api slash user. Now it's trying to login page. That's what we have defined here. Okay, without login page, we cannot access anything. Now if you want to access this user, we need to login with the user. That user should have a user role. Joe is here. When you see this user configuration, Joe is the user role, right? I want to login with Joe. The password is 123. 123. Yeah. See, I'm able to access this particular endpoint using user Joe because he is having a user role. Let's try with different user. Admin. See, the admin does not have that endpoint access. See, forbidden. Because I defined only this page access only for user role, not for admin, not for super admin. Even if you pass super admin, it will not work. Okay. Now I want to log out and log in as admin. How to log out? Say log out. Now log in as admin. Admin is a mark, password is a 123. Going back to the home page. Now I say user API slash user. He does not have access to the user access because he is having only admin access. I'll go and say admin. See, he is having an admin access, so I'm able to access that endpoint. Even super admin does not have access now. Okay, now I want to log in as a super admin. Super admin is a Suresh. Before that, I need to log out. Log out. Suresh, password is 123. Now Suresh does not have an access of user as well as admin. He can access only super admin page. Okay. Now according to this configuration, our endpoint is working right. Now I want to provide these two page access to super admin. That is done by using has any role. Has any role. There is another method called has any role. In that has any role, we can pass multiple roles. Comma super admin. Comma super admin. Here also you have to mention has any roles, right? Okay. Now this super admin can access this particular endpoint. Apart from that, this super admin can access user as well as admin. Let's test that now. Okay. Okay, I'll go and log out. Okay. Login as a log out. Okay. Login as a, we are login as a Suresh. This is a super user, right? 123. Going back to the home page. Now API slash user is a, now we are able to access the user page. Able to access the admin page. Access the, he is able to access the super admin page. Okay. Now login to log out and login as a Joe. He is a user role. He can access only user page. He cannot access admin page. He cannot access super admin page. Similarly, admin user also. I'll go to show that also. No worries. Admin is a mark. He cannot access user page. He can access admin page. He cannot access super admin page. That's it. I hope you are clear this particular session. Now I see here I'm using the, I'm not encoding the password, right? The, not encoding password, not good idea. We have to encode the password, okay? The real-time project, we have to encode the password. We cannot live like this. So how to encode the password? That also will be part of this video. Now to say new, there is a one class called bcrypt password encoder. Just return this. Then in the password section, we have to call one method called password encoder, get password encoder dot encode. Get password encoder dot encode. Get password encoder dot encode. Okay, now I'm going to restart the application. So whenever I type a username and a password, that password encoded by the Spring Boot application. It will not send directly as a text format. It will go and encrypt the password and send. Okay. If you want to do this implementation some years back, we have to write our code. We have to write encoding logic. Okay. That is not at all. We cannot. That is totally eliminated because of Spring Boot magic. Everything taken care by Spring Boot. Okay, now I want to log out. Sorry. Log out. I want access. Joey is a user. 1, 2, 3. So I'm able to access. API stack. So I'm able to log in with the encrypted password, right? Yeah, that's it guys, today's session. Hope you enjoyed this particular video. We're going to see a lot more about the Spring security in upcoming videos. Okay, still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it, share this video to your friend circle, click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video. Until then, bye bye from Suresh.